Oh, these are happy tears. These are happy tears. Hey everybody, it's your girl Janani. Welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, welcome. I'm so glad that you decided to tune in today. So you guys, today's video is going to be a little bit different. I am going to actually open two boxes today. I'm going to open a box from Mickey Loot, and I'm also going to open a box from Bippity. Yeah, I know, a 2-in-1 from two different companies in one video. And that is just because there is so much going on. My house is currently in shambles right now. And that is because I am moving. I am moving after 11 and a half long years. I am returning home to California. And before I landed this job, I was actually thinking about the future of this channel. Subscription boxes are expensive. So I was actually thinking that December would be my last subscription boxes with Mickey Loot and Bippity for a while. So I'm gonna pause them just because I'm gonna have some new things going on. However, I'm gonna be close to Disneyland again, which is really exciting. So I think the direction of this channel is kind of going to be vlogs, Disneyland content, Downtown Disney, Sperry Farm, Universal Studios, City Walk, just all kind of local Southern California attractions and vlogs and things that you can do in California. I think that's going to be the direction of this channel until I decide to renew my subscription boxes, if I do. And if I do, I'll incorporate that in. So this channel is going to look a little bit different, and I'm excited, and I hope you guys are too, and I hope that you guys will stick around. Another update that's going on, you guys might have noticed the sound coming out of my mouth. I don't sound like my usual self, and that is because I just discovered this morning that I have COVID. Yeah, after all that, since COVID's been here, never been sick, nothing. Full disclaimer, I am fully vaccinated. Been to Disney World, Disneyland, everything. And then all of a sudden I get COVID because I was exposed to a friend of the family during Christmas. With me being vaccinated, I am actually not doing bad at all. There was one day I was just really tired and fatigued, and I just slept all day, and I woke up the next day feeling better. I've just been congested and kind of had like this whole frog in my throat thing with like mucus and phlegm and all that gross stuff. But other than that, I feel fine. Like, I'm not running a fever or anything. So for a while I just thought maybe I had a cold, until I sat down for dinner the other night and I couldn't taste anything when I was able to taste something the day before. So I immediately went to a drive-through testing site and got the COVID test, and then they alerted me this morning that I have tested positive for COVID. So I have been careful. I've pretty much been quarantining in my house. I am also working remotely. So during the day I am working, and then once I get off, I'll pack, or early in the morning before I clock in, I'll pack. So, I mean, I've been productive while I've been having COVID, because like I said, I don't feel bad. I've been, you know, taking medicine, drinking lots of fluids, and then resting when my body tells me to rest. But other than that, I just feel fine. It's just my voice that's annoying more than anything. So without further ado, let's open the first box, which is going to be the Mickey Loot box. So here's a box. It's pretty small. It doesn't have a lot of weight, but it's not light either. I just opened the box and we have a mermaid. And you know, Mickey Loot kind of does this thing with foreshadowing with their postcards and what's in the box. Very beautiful, very pretty mermaid drawing. And then, you know, we always get the handwritten note, Janani, enjoy your box, Mickey Loot. All right, so I'm opening her up, and first thing that's jumping out of me is a shirt, and it's a Cusco shirt. Emperor's New Groove, Cuscotopia. Mickey Loot is always sending me Cusco stuff. The Emperor's New Groove is one of my favorite movies. Oh my gosh, and this shirt is so soft. Look how bright and beautiful this is. Cuscotopia. And I actually have the Cuscotopia lounge fly that they send me in one of my previous boxes, and I always take it with me to Walt Disney World, and every time I do, people stop me and ask me where I get my backpack from. So Cuscotopia shirt. Thank you, Mickey Loot. Next item, we have a Danielle Nicole wallet, you guys, and it is a Moana. So we have the leaves going on here, and at the bottom there it says Danielle Nicole. And then if we turn it around, we have a baby Moana in the ocean, when she's first getting to know the ocean, and they select her as the chosen one, giving her the heart of Tafiti. So cute. I love the coloring. The camera's not doing it justice, but the colors are so bright and vivid. It's beautiful. Next, what's in the box is we have a keychain. One thing that's different about this box, nothing is individually wrapped. We know Mickey Loop does like the individually wrapped things, but it is all good. But we have a keychain, and it's a dingle hopper. The Little Mermaid, Ariel's not one of my favorite princesses, but I do like her, do not get me wrong. And if it's one thing I do like about The Little Mermaid, it's the whole dingle hopper reference. I think it's really, really cute. The one thing that I will say about this, though, is that I wish it was maybe made out of like stainless steel or something like that. Like, the material is plastic, and I feel like if I'm not careful with this, this is just going to snap in half. Next item, we have a Star Wars box. Y'all know I have turned into a Star Wars geek since COVID has started, okay? So it's some kind of piece of jewelry. Let's take a look. I love it. So we have earrings. Here are the earrings. So one thing about me is, like, when it comes to fandom jewelry, I do not like big gaudy pieces. I like them to be dainty, and these are the daintiest things ever. We have Darth Vader, we have Princess Leia, so all kinds of little characters referencing Star Wars. Oh, there's also the Millennium Falcon up there, and then R2-D2 down there as well. Really, really cute. I love them. All right, friends, so that's everything in the Mickey Loop box. Another thing that's different about this box is that I didn't receive a packing slip. However, there are the prices on all of the items. So my dainty little Star Wars earrings, these are worth $24.99. The Dingle Hopper keychain, I'm not sure what it's worth. It just says, you know, red. If you shop at the World of Disney and things like that, you know that you shop by category, and they have like red, yellow, blue, and then like it'll tell you what the price is or the price range. So unfortunately, I don't remember off the top of my head, but this is a red category item. And the Danielle Nicole Moana wallet, this retail value is $16.90. That was a Mickey Loop box. It was a cute little box. Like I said, I could have did without the Dingle Hopper keychain, though it's a cute reference to The Little Mermaid. But like I said, it feels a little bit flimsy and like I would break it. But cute box nonetheless. Now let's get into this Bippity box. So here's our Bippity box. This is a big old box we have here. So I went ahead and cut and opened the box off camera because it's a big old box. And the first thing we get, of course, is our holiday postcard. I love their holiday postcards. And of course, we have our packing slip, which is going to tell us the retail value. I cannot talk. Which is going to tell us the retail value of each item in the box. This is what's in the box. This is the only thing in the box that's wrapped up, so I'm just gonna rip her open like it's Christmas Day. By the way, I hope you all had a Merry Christmas, Happy Holiday, or just enjoy some time off. If you do not celebrate Christmas, Hanukkah, Kwanzaa, or any of the other holiday celebrations that may relate to your culture or religion, but I just hope everyone had a good one. Okay, so we have a few things, and they're all facing down. First thing that's coming out at me is we have Loungefly. Y'all know what this means. We have some ears. I am wondering if these are the Christmas wreath ears. So when we went to Walt Disney World during Thanksgiving, I had saw these wreath ears. I had not seen them outside the parks. I hadn't seen them at Disneyland or anything. And I kept playing with the notion of whether I wanted them or not. I decided not to get them. 2 days later, they dropped on Shop Disney. They sold out everywhere, and I was so upset with myself because I should have got them. So I did tell Bippity that I wanted the wreath ears, and if they could find them, please give them to me. I'm wondering if these are it, but I'm thinking not, just because I think those wreath ears were a Disney park item. But anyway, let's open her up and see. All right, I'm really, really nervous. Okay, so I have some other ears that I wanted. Let me show you. They're the Mickey and Minnie snowman ears. I think these are freaking adorable. I never cared for like ears on ears, you know what I mean? Because it's like Mickey and Minnie with their ears on ears. Until I ran into Molly at Epcot during Festival of the Holidays, and she had the candy cane stripe ones from Disneyland, and I thought they were the cutest thing ever, and I kind of fell in love with them. And then I saw these, and I was like, you know what? Yep, they're mine. I need to have these too. But I couldn't find these in the parks either, so I'm happy for these. Thank you. All right, so next item, this is some kind of painting of some sort. It's all bubble wrapped. It's like wrapped in wood. I am secretly hoping this is a Thomas Kinkade Disney painting. I love art. I grew up on Thomas Kinkade. My mom has Thomas Kinkade art in her house. Thomas Kinkade just does beautiful, beautiful work. So I am secretly hoping that's what this is. Oh, let's see, I'm excited, I'm so excited. And they have bubble wrapped this to death. Okay, so on the back, it is a Thomas Kinkade. It says Certificate of Authenticity. This is hereby certified as a genuine Thomas Kinkade Studios product. Now to flip it over and see what picture we got. Okay. I'm so happy. Hold on.
A few moments later.
Okay. Oh, these are happy tears. These are happy tears because I really wanted this painting. Let me show you. I'm not going to take it out of the plastic just because I'm moving, so I'm going to keep it packaged as is, but let me show you what the picture is. Here is the picture, and it's of Cinderella Castle at Disney World. From my understanding, this picture was actually retiring and going away. But here's a picture. You see the fireworks, Cinderella's castle, families on Main Street, and it's absolutely beautiful. Okay, let me kind of explain to you why this picture is so emotional for me. Okay, excuse my crying face. So if you guys have been following me, you guys know that I am a Disney nerd. I love Disney. I've been exposed to Disney my entire life. I grew up going to Disneyland since my first time at Disneyland. My mom was pregnant with me, okay? So Disneyland is my home park. I remember being 4 years old, watching the July 4th Spectacular. I believe it was 1988 at Disney World, and I fell in love. I remember telling my family, I want to go there, let's go. And I remember them basically saying, we can't afford to go there, you have Disneyland, stick to what you know. For years, I've been wanting to go to Disney World. A couple of times we have planned some family trips. You know how you used to order the vacation planning DVDs from Disney World? We had a couple of those. We had picked where we were going to stay, and it fell through. We never went. For 32 years, I have been dreaming of going to Walt Disney World and seeing Cinderella's castle and going to Epcot and just doing all the Walt Disney World things. Well, last year, 2021, I made that a reality. I went to Disney World, just my son and I, for 10 glorious days, March 2021, for the first time. And I have a vlog of it. If you haven't watched that vlog, make sure you watch that vlog. But when I entered those gates and I walked down Main Street, and I saw Cinderella's castle for the first time, I lost it. And a lot of people might think it's dumb, or a lot of people might think it's stupid, but for me, I was that little four-year-old girl again who had been dreaming of seeing this castle and finally seeing it. It was very much a, I'm here, I can't believe I'm here, a mama, I made it moment. And to know that I did it myself and was able to bring my son. And Cinderella's castle for me, it just holds all of my childhood hopes and dreams. It's basically the embodiment of it, which is why Cinderella's castle is so special to me and why I'm so emotional over it. And so for me to receive this painting, I will have that forever and always. I will have Cinderella's castle in my house and what the castle means to me and what it represents for me, and also just the great time and the memories and the bonding that me and my son had while our first time at Walt Disney World, and even every time we go to Walt Disney World or even a Disney park, it is very much a bonding moment for us. Like, that's what we do, that's our place. So Okay, that's why. All right, let's take a look at the spoiler sheet and see how much the items are worth. So my Loungefly ears, Mickey and Minnie snowman ears, these are worth $30. And my beautiful Thomas Kinkade Walt Disney World Cinderella Castle wrapped canvas, this item is worth $90. Actually, I'm sorry, it's worth $99. So that brings the total retail value of my box to $129. Thank you all so much for tuning in with me, for opening these boxes with me, for listening to me. There's a lot of new things coming and I am excited and terrified at the same time. Overall, I think these were great boxes. Bippity just blew me away like they always do. So again, thank you all so much for tuning in, and there is more to come. And as always, I like to hear from you guys. Leave me your thoughts, questions, comments, concerns, words of encouragement, anything that you want to leave me down in the comments below. I love engaging with you guys. Until next time, I hope you all have a magical, magical day. Bye. Ooh, and I'm keeping this bubble wrap, honey. I need to wrap my gym short figurines. Okay.